Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to the 2014 inaugural meeting. And I will first start it off by turning it over to Councillor Starterboom, who will start us off with O Canada. I would now like to introduce the Kwantlen First Nation and invite them to perform the welcome and honor song. Please be seated. Thank you very much. I would like to now call the 2014 Inaugural Council meeting to order, and invite Judge Hamilton to come forth and administer the oath of office to the mayor.
Are you?
If you could please repeat after me. I, Theodore J. Schaefer.
I, Theodore J. Schaefer.
Do solemnly swear that.
Do solemnly swear that.
I am qualified to hold the office of mayor for the city of Langley.
I am qualified to hold the office of mayor for the city of Langley.
To which I have been elected.
To which I have been elected.
I have not by myself or any other person.
I have not by myself or any other person.
Knowingly contravened the Local Government Act.
Knowingly contravened the Local Government Act.
Respecting vote buying or intimidation.
Respecting vote buying or intimidation.
In relation to my election to the office.
In relation to my election to the office.
I will faithfully perform the duties of my office.
I will faithfully perform the duties of my office.
And will not allow any private interest.
And will not allow any private interest.
To influence my conduct in public matters.
To influence my conduct in public matters.
As required by the community charter.
As required by the community charter.
I will disclose any direct or indirect pecuniary interest.
I will disclose any direct or indirect pecuniary interest I have in any matter.
And will not participate in the discussion of the matter.
And will not participate in the discussion of the matter.
And will not vote in respect of the matter.
And will not vote in respect of the matter.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
I would now like to invite Councillor Tumianot of the Kwinana First Nation to come forward for the placing of the chain of office over the mayor's head.
Thank you. It's an honor and a privilege for our chief, Marilyn Gabriel, my fellow council member, Les Antone, and myself, Tumia Nott, and our drummers and singers from our community to be a part of this very special day, an important day. We very much at Kwantlen value the relationship that we have with the city of Langley, and we thank you from the bottom of our hearts for including us in this ceremony. It's very meaningful for us to be a part of days like today. As our nation gets stronger, we experience many of the same journeys that all levels of government, big and small, share. And I have to reflect today on the chain of office, and I do reflect in terms of our own traditions, and in our culture, leaders of our communities, the CMs, would wear beautifully woven blankets that would take years and years to create, and I see similarities in terms of this beautiful chain and the chief's robes that our leaders would wear. And again, just as a sign of leadership, as a sign of the important work that they are doing on behalf of their communities. So it's an honor to be able to bestow the chain on your worship, Mayor, and all the best.
I would now invite Judge Hamilton back to administer the oath of office for our counselors.
If you could repeat after me. I. Do solemnly affirm that. I am qualified to hold the office of counselor.
I am qualified to hold the office of counselor.
For the city of Langley.
For the city of Langley.
To which I have been elected.
To which I have been elected.
I have not by myself, or any other person, knowingly contravened the Local Government Act, respecting vote buying,
or intimidation,
in relation to my election to the office. I will faithfully perform the duties of my office, and will not allow any private interest to influence my conduct in public matters. As required by the community charter, I will disclose any direct or indirect pecuniary interest I have in a matter, and will not participate in the discussion of the matter, and will not vote in respect of the matter. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Ask Councillor Albrecht to please come forward and sign your oath. Councillor Jack Arnold. Councillor Rudy Storderboom. Councillor Dave Hall. Councillor Gail Martin. Mm-hmm. And Councillor Val Vandenbroek. Thank you. I'd ask the councillors to please take their seats, and I will turn the meeting over to His Worship, Mayor Schaefer.
Thank you, Ms. Mishara. It's now my pleasure to introduce Pastor Dave McTaggart, who is going to give the invocation.
The Langley Christian leaders pray for you, and the scriptures encourage us to do that, that we in Langley can live a good and peaceable and quiet life. And so we thank you for your service. When Mayor Ted Schaefer asked me, there was a verse that came to mind that I would like to read before I pray. And it's from an Old Testament prophet named Micah. And I'm reading in a contemporary version. It says, God has plainly made it plain how to live, what to do, and what he's looking for in men and women. It is quite simple. Do what is fair and just to your neighbor. Be compassionate and loyal in your love, and don't take yourselves too seriously. Take God seriously. Essentially, he's saying, act justly, do what is right, love mercy, be kind and gracious, and walk humbly. May we pray. Our Father in heaven, we acknowledge you as Lord and Creator, our God and our Savior. And today we ask your blessing and your guidance upon the counselors, upon our mayor, as they lead us, as they make decisions. And I pray, Father, that they would act justly in all of the city's affairs. I ask you, Lord, that they would ask with mercy and compassion. And finally, that they would walk humbly as they serve you, as they serve the city. I thank you for them, and I pray, God, that you would give them wisdom and guidance in their decisions. And I ask you, Lord, that you would bless them and keep them, that you would make your face to shine upon them and be gracious unto them, and Lord, that you would lift up your countenance upon them and give them peace. And I ask this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you very much. I'd like to now introduce some special guests. I have the new Councillor Jack Arnold, the new Councillor Paul Albrecht, the new Councillor Rudy Storderbroom, the new Councillor Gail Martin, the new Councillor Val Vandenbroek, and the new Councillor Dave Hall. As guests of honor here today, we have the Honorable Judge Rob Hamilton, Pastor Dave McTaggart, Piper Mike McDonald. We have Kwantlen First Nations Chief Marilyn Gabriel and her husband Kevin Kelly, and Michael Kelly Gabriel as well. Councillor Toomey Knott, Councillor Les Anton, Michelle Saul, and Richard Stewart. The RCMP Honor Guard, we have Corporal David Conga, Corporal Shannon Savinoff. Fire Service Officers, behind me here, are Andy Berg, Dave Skidmore, and Dan Gray. From the Township of Langley today, it's my pleasure to see Jack Froese and his wife Debbie. Thank you. David Davies was going to try and make it. I'm not sure whether he made it into the audience. Could be outside. Angie Qualley. We have school. And Bob Long. Yes, Bob Long. Former. Sneaking in on us. And school trustees, Rob McFarlane and Shelley Coburn. Outgoing city councillor, Terry James, and school trustee and ex-city councillor, Rosemary Wallace. And outgoing school trustee, Wendy Johnson, who was the chair. She's sitting in the back. And it really is a pleasure for me today to have three of the past mayors here today. Peter Fassbender couldn't make it, but in reverse order, I have former Mayor Aubrey Searle, former Mayor Joe Lopashinsky, and former Mayor Marlene Grinnell. Representing the Royal Canadian Legion, and they are freedom of, they have the freedom of the city, is Shirley Blair, and President, she's President, and David Brocklehurst. And Superintendent Murray Power from the RCMP. Suzanne Hoffman, who is the school superintendent for District 35. And we have quite a few dignitaries here. I'm quite honored and privileged to see them all. Christine Simpson, president, and Lynn Whitehouse from the Chamber of Commerce here. Deborah Kulinishki from the Tourism Langley. And there are very many volunteers here from our select groups and committees that we have in the city, all our boards. There's so many of them, I couldn't name them all, but representing the board, APC, Parks and Rec, and that they're in the audience someplace. So thank you. And the senior management team, the people that make our lives so much easier. We have Francis Chung, our CAO. We have Darren Light, Rory Thompson, Kim Hilton, Gerald Minchuk, Rick Baumhoff, Carolyn Machada, and Judy Hale. And last but not least, Andrew Brown, who is the president of QP 2058. It's now my honor and privilege to do the inaugural address. Good afternoon. So on behalf of my fellow council members, Paul Albrecht, Jack Arnold, Dave Hall, Gail Martin, Rudy Storterboom, and Val Vandenbroek, did I mention you, Gail? Gail Martin. We are deeply honored to be sworn in today as the City of Langley's 38th Council. I'm very honored and privileged to have these six people here at my side. We are humbled by the trust that you have placed on us to provide the leadership that is required to move the City of Langley forward and seize our bright future. In 2015, we will be celebrating our 60th year as a municipal government. There is so much to be proud of in the City of Langley. As a community, we can celebrate the positive growth and the great many achievements and successes that have taken place in recent years. As we've grown, we've managed to retain our small city atmosphere and community spirit while offering all the amenities of a major urban center. This has proven to be a unique trait that appeals to a wide spectrum of people and businesses. We continue to be aggressively at the forefront of economic development opportunities and have made positive strides revitalizing our downtown core, including transforming previous brownfield contaminated or vacant sites into economically viable employment destinations that attract investors to our city. We've been recognized nationally, provincially, and regionally for our innovative land use plans, economic development strategies, and ongoing commitment to the success of our local business community. Most recently, the Federation of Canadian Municipalities named the City of Langley as one of the winners of its 2015 Sustainable Communities Award, recognizing innovation and excellence in municipal sustainable development. This commitment to improving the livability of our city is reaffirmed in our recently completed Master Transportation Plan to address growth and shape long-term investment in the city's transportation infrastructure and programs over the next 20 years. It is also at the heart of our new Parks, Recreation, and Culture Master Plan, which aims to guide the development and expansion of our parks and trails, playgrounds, recreation and cultural facilities, as well as the programs and services needed to meet the needs of our changing and vibrant community. However, as a council, and more importantly, as your neighbors, we recognize that there is still much work to be done. As we continue to build upon our successes, we, as a community, must continue to address the issues that face our community and seize the opportunities that are before us. Guiding the city's planning process is the 2013 to 2017 strategic plan. The plan emphasizes seven key result areas: improving our infrastructure, enhancing the quality of life in our city, communicating with our residents more effectively, revitalizing our downtown core, protecting, preserving, restoring, sustaining, and enhancing our environment, ensuring that our citizens' safety and security, and investing in the organizational development. As we move forward into 2015, addressing public safety concern continues to be a top priority. As part of the city's crime reduction strategy, over the last year, new policing initiatives have resulted in a marked improvement in key areas. We will continue to work closely with the Langley RCMP, Transit Police, our bylaw enforcement team, community partners, and other stakeholders to ensure that we're being responsive to the needs of our community. I am confident that by working together, we will be successful in the continued downward trend of our crime statistics, leading to an enhanced feeling of safety and security. As a core city, we recognize that homelessness is a challenging and complicated social issue. Work is currently underway on a proposal to create a homelessness task force to facilitate collaborative ideas generation and multi-jurisdictional approach to homelessness and affordable housing. Senior staff members are working on the terms of reference and should have a proposal ready for council in the new year. Transportation continues to be a top priority, not only for the city of Langley, but the region as a whole. We've been working closely with the Township of Langley, the City of Surrey, the Corporation of Delta, and the City of White Rock on various transportation initiatives. These include the pursuit of rapid transit connecting Surrey City Centre to Langley Centre along Fraser Highway. As part of the Mayor's Council on Regional Transportation, we have created an ambitious but practical vision for the next 30 years. The plan focuses on growing the economy, protecting the environment, and improving our quality of life. This ambitious transportation vision has been approved by the Mayor's Council on Regional Transportation. We hope this vision and related transportation network improvements receive public support in the upcoming referendum in the spring of 2015. As we work towards achieving our goals, the ultimate challenge I see facing our community is the management of expectations. As a council, we have the difficult task of balancing the need to retain competitive taxation levels with our efforts to not only maintain, but also enhance infrastructure, municipal services, and ultimately our citizens' quality of life. This requires thoughtful prioritization based on feedback from the community, as well as finding solutions to help offset the pressures of taxation. Through wise allocation of casino proceeds and with our valued partnerships with community service providers, we are able to fund important infrastructure projects and support the provision of much-needed community services without an impact to taxpayers. We also recognize that the business and development sectors are key partners in helping us to implement our community plans and to revitalize the city. We are grateful to the Greater Langley Chamber of Commerce and the Downtown Langley Business Association for their efforts in helping us to create an open for business culture. Investing in the success of our local business community and attracting potential investors, developers, and business owners is an investment in our city's future. Communication and collaboration are key to local government success. Citizen engagement and feedback strengthen the quality of policymaking, programs, and service delivery. As a council, we need to expand opportunities to enhance communication to better engage our citizens in municipal decision-making processes and better communicate our objectives, strategies, and vision for our city. As we embark upon our future, we must continue to support volunteerism and celebrate our unique community spirit. It is that heart of our community, an integral part of the success of our beautiful city. In conclusion, I would like to recognize my colleague Peter Fassbender for his leadership and dedication to our community, and thank our retiring members of council, Terry James and Rosemary Wallace, for your longtime service. It has been a great pleasure to work with you, and I wish you all the very best. I would like to acknowledge our exceptionally dedicated and hardworking staff who provide our community with excellent and responsive customer service. And to our new council, I look forward to working with you to address the challenges and opportunities before us. While we may not always agree, we will respect each other's opinions as we share a common vision and passion to do our very best in serving the citizens of the City of Langley. And to our citizens, I pledge my commitment to represent you with the positive leadership and to be a strong advocate for our city in dealing with regional and provincial issues that have a direct impact on our quality of life. Our council will work diligently to fulfill our mission to build a vibrant, healthy, safe community. With that said, the responsibility belongs to all of us to ensure that the City of Langley always remains a community that we are proud to call home. If you are passionate about an issue, we encourage you to get involved and to help effect the change that you want to see in our community. We must continue to work together to move the City of Langley in a positive and forward direction. We must challenge ourselves to forever maintain our reputation as the place to be. Thank you. It's now my pleasure to make the appointment for Deputy Mayor. I need a motion. So moved by Councillor Albrecht, seconded by Councillor Hall, that the following persons be appointed Deputy Mayor for the year 2015 as followed: Councillor Jack Arnold, December 1st, 2014 to January 31st, 2015. Councillor Paul Albrecht, February 1st to March 31st, 2015. Councillor Rudy Storderboom, April 1st to May 31st, 2015. Councillor Gail Martin, June 1st to July 31st, 2015. Councillor Val Vandenbroek, August 1st to September 30th, 2015. Councillor Dave Hall, October 1st to November 30th, 2015. And I now need a vote. All those in favor? It's unanimous 4. Appointment to boards, Metro Vancouver. And that Councillor Rudy Storderboom be appointed to the Greater Vancouver Regional District Board of Directors for 2015, and that Councillor Gail Martin be appointed as an alternate. I need a mover and a seconder. Councillor Jack Arnold, seconded by Paul Albrecht. All those in favor? It's unanimous 4. And another one is that Councillor Gail Martin be appointed to the Fraser Valley Regional Library Board for 2015, and that Councillor Paul Albrecht be appointed as an alternate. I need a mover and a seconder. Councillor Val Vanderbilt, Councillor Rudy Storderboom. All those in favor? It's unanimous 4. Under other business, I've asked each council member to say a couple of words for people that they care for in their life. I'll start with Councillor Hall.
Am I on? Okay, during the election campaign, I went to the door of a citizen, and a middle-aged man comes to the door and he says, "Do you know whose house you're at?" And I said, "Sure I do." And he says, "And you still want to go in and talk to the old guy?" And I said, "Yeah, former castle, goes way back, he's in his 80s. first thing he says to me, he says, Dave, we made some really good decisions. I think we left the city in pretty good shape. And what I'd like you to do is just make those same decisions and shut your yap, because you talk too much. So I'm going to try to take that advice today and be very brief. It's not about me today. It's about welcoming a new mayor with some new, fresh perspectives that's now been endorsed by the electorate. It's about some returning councillors that bring some historical perspective, and there's real value in that. And there's welcoming of some new people with some fresh, new ideas. It's about thanking friends and family for what they've done during the campaigns and the sacrifices that they made, and those sacrifices aren't over. For the next 4 years, those people will make some sacrifices that we all should value very much. So thank you to those people. The other day I posted on a Facebook for Chris Muhammad's birthday, something that came out of my head, I don't know why. And I thought it's just as appropriate for his birthday as it is right now for this, so here it is. Today is as easily forgotten as yesterday, as long as tomorrow's better than either. I look forward to going forward. Thank you.
I'd just like to thank everybody for coming today. This is my, I'm the newbie, I'm one of the newbies. Can everybody hear me? Okay, sorry, can't really hear up here. First off, I'd like to thank my mom and stepdad for coming over from Canberra River today. And I'd also like to thank my husband who supported me 100% through this whole crazy election thing. When I went to him and said I wanted to do it, he kind of looked at me and went, really? And he's like, yeah, it's the job for you. So here I am, and I'd like to thank all the voters and everybody that supported me throughout it. And I'm looking forward to this new beginning in my life, a kind of a new career path. And I look forward to learning everything I can from everybody up here and all the staff. It was great this morning coming in to get photos done, and working for the city for 8 years and being gone for the last couple months and coming back to City Hall and walking through the hallways and seeing everybody. And it was like coming home to family again. And so thanks to all the staff for making me feel really good. And thanks to all of you. And I look forward to the next 4 years, definitely. Thanks.
I'm an oldie. That was a newbie, I'm an oldie. First of all, I'd like to thank all the citizens of Langley City that have supported me over the years and decided to send me back here. I love doing what I'm doing. And I'm looking forward to this four-year term with this new council. I'd also like to thank my good friend Vicky, who walked the streets with me tirelessly over the campaign. We had lots of fun. And to my daughter-in-law, Nicole, who is here today. My son couldn't be here, and I never thought I'd be sitting in this seat looking at a granddaughter in the audience, but she's somewhere right now, probably sleeping in the counselor's office, so I'm so grateful that she's here, along with Nicole's mom, Linda. They've supported me over the years, and I appreciate it very much, and thank you so much for being here today.
It's a great day in the city of Langley. And it's wonderful to be here in a room full of supporters and friends and family. Thank you very much for coming. I'm happy for this opportunity to thank God for my family, friends, and supporters. I want to honor my father, who passed away last year, and I want to honor my grandfather, who served on City Council in Holland. I'm especially grateful for my healthy, happy, and loving mother. And for my family, Michael, Christine, Rick, Haley, and Diana, for being here with me today, and my Uncle Gary from Maple Ridge. Thank you very much for making the crossing. Also, I want to thank and acknowledge Eric, Lisa, and Hannah, who could not be here, as well as my sister, Rosalyn, who was reelected to the Board of Education in Fraser Cascade. Thank you for your encouragement and support. I offer my respect to our First Nations friends and neighbors. We share the land where we live. I want to thank the veterans and the uniformed service personnel who serve our country and our community to protect our way of life. We can celebrate our democracy and our enduring freedom because of them. Thank you to City Council who served here in the past. We will continue to build on the solid foundation that you have established. Thank you to my current council colleagues for choosing to serve. Thank you for the voters who have given us an excellent team on council. Plus, we already have a city staff and employees that are second to none. Thank you to the candidates for City Council who have our best interests at heart and continue to serve in our community and will serve here in the future. Thank you to business and labor for working together to create opportunities and good jobs in our community. Also, special thanks to our churches and our community service groups and volunteers for their ongoing commitments of acceptance and support for all of the residents of Langley City. We are strong together. This is a good time to remember our city's motto, strength of purpose, spirit of community, our vision for the place to be, and our mission to build a vibrant, healthy, and safe community. I am sincerely grateful for the opportunity to serve and represent you for Langley City. God bless the city of Langley and all who call us their home.
Yeah, thanks for everyone being here. It's a fantastic showing, and I want to congratulate all my fellow council members. I also want to thank all the candidates who ran. I really do appreciate the energy and the passion they brought to the campaign, as well as the friendships that we developed over that path. This was an interesting and long journey, and it's been extremely rewarding, and I do know that the real work is just about to begin. I want to give, I can't express enough gratitude and thanks to my friends, my family, all the volunteers that helped me out in this campaign. My wife, Christine, your supportive and understanding nature and unwavering support is just, I can't say enough. To my mother, for making me the man I am today, and to the residents of the city of Langley, I am humbled and honored with the support and the trust that you've bestowed upon me. I am ready to roll up my sleeves and get to work in the best interest of our community. I look forward to the challenges ahead, and I thank you all very much.
Well, thank you everybody for coming. I think this is the biggest crowd I've seen in 24 years, and that's always a good sign. I guess also I want to thank everyone who voted, regardless of who they voted for, because that's what democracy is about, and that's what people went out and exercised, was that right? My daughter is not here because somebody in the family has to make some money, and so she couldn't make it today, but I do want to thank all of the people who are on this council. And I guess the one thing that people have always asked me about being on council this long, and I've said that there are some councils where people won't be seen in the same room with each other if they don't have to be. Our council has always, in the 24 years I've been here, we might sit at this table and go at it hot and heavy, but when we're done, we can all go out for coffee together. And that makes it so much better to work together and to be able to get things done. That's just the type of atmosphere that we have here in the city, not just on council, but I think in the whole city. And so I think I'm looking forward to the next 4 years, and I hope to see you all around.
It's now my pleasure. I would like to thank my wife, Jean. She has stood at my side, helped me along all the way, and at times been my voice of reason and sounding board. You have to fully understand how I can be in it. Not that I'm difficult, but To my daughters, Kirsten and Jennifer, thank you for being at Pop's side. I could not have done it without you. To my sister, Bev, and my godfather, Mr. Wolf Diggerman is here. It's kind of cool to have your family here. My mom isn't. So you've been there when I needed you. I'd also like to thank my many friends, and most importantly, the residents of Langley City for their support. I truly mean it. Now, I'm just a regular guy in a fancy suit, so. In closing, I am ever grateful to my immediate staff, Deborah, Christy, and Paula, and to all the staff who work so hard and make me look good, which isn't always easy. Thank you. Come to that end. So I need a mover and a second to adjourn. Councillor Arnold, Councillor Storybroom, all those in favor? It's unanimous. We've closed.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Any senior attention.
Good job.
Well.